Hello everyone, welcome back to our economics class. In the last classes we have discussed topic from unit number 8, that is public revenue, then various items of public expenditure and also the methods of redemption of public debt. Today's topic is also from unit number 8, that is supply creates its own demand, which is also a 5 marks topic. Alright, let us start with the concept. First point, there are totally 6 points in this topic. Let us go with the first point. J.B. Say states that supply creates its own demand. Now, the question arises, who is J.B. Say? Obviously, the subject which we are reading is economics. Then he is an economist. Who is J.B. Say? An economist. So, what is he saying? He have given a statement that supply creates its own demand. That means whatever demand will be there, supply will be that much only, or whatever supply will be there, demand will be equal to that. So in simple terms, whatever the demand is there, supply will be that much. For example, if the persons are demanding for more types of Samsung mobiles, that means the shopkeeper must be increasing the supply of Samsung mobiles. Am I right? So here what is happening? Demand is based upon supply and supply is based upon demand. So what J.B. Say is saying that supply creates its own demand. This is a statement given by J.B. Say. Coming to the second point, the classical theory of employment is also based upon Say's law of market. So this is a name of a theory, that is classical theory of employment. In economist you have various theories. Among that, classical theory is also one of a kind. So this theory is also based upon Say's law of market. You can observe from this law, Say's is there. Say's means what? J.B. Say. Just now we have discussed about him, right? So he have also formed a law that is called as Say's law of market. So in total we have discussed about 3 things. First is the statement of J.B. Say, that is supply creates its own demand. Second is the theory. Which theory? Classical theory. Third we have discussed is law. Whose law? Say's law of market. So what is Say's law of market telling you? It is telling the same statement that supply creates its own demand. Don't get confused. It is very simple. In first point we are saying that J.B. Say states that supply creates its own demand. That means he gave a statement. In second point we are saying there is also a theory which is based upon the Say's law of market. Now what is Say's law of market? We'll discuss in third point. The above law says that supply is always equals to demand. Supply is always equals to demand. We can also write it as S is equals to D. For example, you have arranged a party for 20 members. Okay, it's a birthday party. You have gave invitation to 20 members. Then what happened? Unfortunately, 30 members have attended your party. So in place of 20 members, 30 members are attending your party. You have arranged the party for 20 members, but 30 members have attended your party. Now what will happen? You have prepared food for how many persons? 20. But extra 10 persons, did you prepare anything? No. So what is happening here? The supply is less and demand is more. This is the first condition. Or else we can also take the second condition. Supply is more and demand is less. So this is not stated in Say's law of market. What Say's law of market is saying? How much supply is there, demand will also be that much. You can say that S is equals to D. For example, you have prepared food for 20 members, then 20 members should attend the party. If you have prepared food for 50 members, 50 members can attend the party. Alright, so how much supply is there? Demand will also be that much only. So supply is always equals to demand, that is S is equals to D. Then coming to fourth one, additional output in the economy is created by the factors of production which participate in the process of production and they get income in the form of rent, wages, interest and profit. In simple terms, in unit number 7, national income, we have discussed that there are four factors of production: land, labor, capital and organization. So these four factors of production will get income in the form of rent, wages, interest, profit. How? Land will get income in the form of rent, labor will get income in the form of wages, land, labor, capital and organization. Capital will get in the form of interest and organization will get income in the form of profits. What are this land, labor, capital and organization? These are the factors of production. They are getting income in the form of rent, wages, interest and profits. The same thing we have discussed here. Very simple. Four factors of production get income in the form of rent, wages, interest and profit. Coming to fifth point. Total income generated is equivalent to the value of output produced. I have highlighted two points here. Income equivalent to output. Equivalent means what? Equal. Income is equals to output. It is written over here. Therefore, income is equals to output. That means how much output is produced, that much income you will receive. For example, if you have manufactured 10 bags of rice, you have manufactured 10 bags of rice, that is your output. When you sell 10 bags of rice, you will get income for those 10 bags of rice. That is your income. Is it right? If you sell 10 bags, you won't get income for 20 bags, right? If you sell 10 bags, you won't get income for 30 bags. How much output you are selling, that much income you will receive. So I can say that income is equals to output, right or not? So therefore, income is equals to output. We have studied first case, that is S is equals to D, supply is equals to demand. Now we are saying I is equals to O, that is income is equals to output. Coming to the sixth point, such income will create additional demand for additional output. We are saying that demand is equals to output. Okay, how much output you are having, that much demand you will be having. Just three important things are there to be discussed. We have read three cases, case 1, case 2 and case 3. First we said that supply is equals to demand. Then second we have said that income is equals to output. Then third we said that demand is equals to output. The topic is completed. Might be it is looking little bit confusing, but it is very easy. Let us just recall it once again. In first point we have discussed about the statement. Second point we have discussed about theory as well as law. J.B. Say have given a statement, that is supply creates its own demand. And also a theory, that is classical theory of employment, it is also based on this law. Which law? Say's law of market. Then third point, this law is saying that supply is always equals to demand, that is S is equals to D. Fourth point, it is saying that factors of production will get income in the form of rent, wages, interest and profits. Fifth point, we are saying that how much output you are producing, that much income you will receive. Means income is equals to output. Then last point, we are saying that some income, the such income which you are receiving for additional demand, they'll be having additional output. An additional demand for an additional output. In simple terms, demand is equals to output. First point we have discussed about the statement. JBC have given a statement, that is supply creates its own demand. Second point we are saying a theory is also based upon this law. Third point we are saying supply is equals to demand. Fourth point we are saying factors of production are getting income in the form of RWIP, rent, wages, interest, profit. Fifth point we are saying that income is equals to output. Last point we are saying that demand is equals to output. The topic is completed. See you in the next class with some new topics. Till that, stay home, stay safe, and keep practicing.